Welcome to Regular High School Hallway, where you can see high school students in their natural habitat. As you can see, all these people reside peacefully in the same world, correct? Not quite, but you already knew that. Anyone that has gone through or is going through the high school slash middle school experience is well aware of the different social groups that are crammed into one building, and of course, how often they collide with each other, resulting in one place. To give some examples of these groups, we have the popular kids, the rebels, the nerds, and the jocks. This collision is mainly the result of rejection due to the social stereotype belonging to each group. Now, here's the lie. You can predetermine someone's personality due to their social group. Why do people tend to believe this? One can come to the conclusion that many people believe this because of the way the media has painted social groups since forever. A great example of this is the movie The Breakfast Club. These and many more have led to people's personalities being labeled due to their social group.
Today and for your constant work towards equality. My name is Valerie and I am 16 years old. I'm also the CEO of the Validation Project. Since 2013, we've been uniting thousands of teenagers internationally, utilizing their passion to take action, breaking the stereotype that age is a barrier in making a difference. Through online leadership training and hundreds of school chapters that represent our mission, we've raised more than $25,000 worth of goods and services donated to people in need, started sports teams for special needs youth, given thousands of cards to battered women's shelters, and advocated for the equality of the LGBT community. The Validation Project is unique because we encourage individuality and use community service to make teenagers' dreams into realities. Why is this so important? Because it is nearly impossible to go through a day without being told who you're supposed to be. Photoshop celebrities remind me that I should have gone to the gym instead of eat a tub of mint chocolate chip ice cream on a Saturday night. Magazine titles intoxicate my mind with the absurd image of beauty I'm supposed to achieve. TV shows and awkward school dances tell me what gender I'm expected to fall in love with. So from the minute I was born, it's been my number one goal to be the all-American teenager. In my family, the motto is, it's good to be weird.
You with the sad eyes.
Don't be discouraged. What were you going, nerd?
It's hard to take a
minute. He was on my way.
Full of people.
You what
can lose sight of it, and the darkness inside you makes you feel so small.
But I see
I encourage you to treat everyone equally, so come and shake hands. No labels!
Labels, they're the cause for the social rejection found in our society.
As we know, this is a never-ending dilemma, but we can put a stop to it. All we need to do is accept each other as we are. There's no need for labeling. Since this is already hard enough for some people, I propose a plan. This means to end all this harassment by simple campaigns. We don't need much. Even a few posters will do.
Stand up to bullying.
By creating this anti-bullying and anti-labeling campaign, we'll be able to make a difference for many people. All we need to do is spread awareness of our actions.